Should you leave your backup drive plugged in? The real risk. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I got. If I leave my external drive plugged in all the time, won't my backups get destroyed or encrypted if my machine gets a virus? Well, there is a risk, yes, but it's a small risk. There are many ways to mitigate that risk, and there's a greater risk at play if you don't leave it plugged in. Let me explain. Let's say your machine becomes infected with malware. That malware is designed to harm not only data on your machine's primary hard drive, but perhaps also any connected drives, including internal, external, or in some cases even network drives. Ransomware, for example, is malware that encrypts all the data that it finds and then holds it for ransom. Many people are concerned that ransomware could thus encrypt your backups. Now, the reason I characterize this as a small risk include most ransomware has actually shifted to targeting larger enterprises. Individuals appear to be less impacted by ransomware of late. Most ransomware focuses on smaller files like documents or photos, which could be encrypted quickly with less chance of the malware being detected until it's too late. Backups, of course, are very large files. Most malware does not seek out external drives. And most malware actually performs different malicious behavior, such as installing keyloggers or other ways to compromise online accounts or crypto mining or sending spam. Now, most is not all, of course. I'm not saying that there's zero risk. I'm just saying that in the grand scheme of things, it is not a big risk. So, mitigating risk. Ransomware is just malware. It is just malware. Happens to be particularly destructive malware if you encounter it, but it's just malware. So there's a good chance you're already mitigating the risk of malware significantly. Run good security software and keep it up to date. Make sure your security software is updating its database of known malware and behavior regularly. Typically, that means every day. Connect to the internet through a router, acting as your firewall. And honestly, if you're not sure, you probably are. Don't click on links you aren't 100% certain of. Don't open attachments you aren't 100% certain of. Don't install software you aren't 100% certain of. That's it. Do the things you already know you should be doing anyway. The chance of malware making it through is small. The chances of malware making it through and wreaking havoc are small. The chances of destructive malware making it through and going after your external drive are smaller yet. It's a small risk of a small risk of a small risk, meaning it's a very small risk. Now, I do have one more mitigation to talk about, but first I want to talk about what I mean by that more critical risk. As you probably know, I'm a huge believer in backups. To be more specific, I believe strongly in automated backups. Backups that, once set up, happen automatically without much further effort on your part. Automated backups, of course, require that the external drive on which your backups are to be placed is connected to your computer. Now, the alternative is to connect to the external drive only when actually performing a backup. This implies that the backup process and that physical connection and disconnection are performed manually. You have to do it. More concerning, you have to remember to do it and take the time to do it. The risk is simple. You'll forget. Please trust me, you will forget, or something else will come up to prevent you from performing the backup. And while I'm not a huge believer in fate and Murphy's Law, it does seem to happen that you'll find you desperately need your backups immediately after having forgotten to create them. To me, that is a much higher risk than malware coming along and trashing the backups you've created because you left the drive attached. Now, there's one more mitigation. The good news here is that a lot of backup software manufacturers understand that people have this fear, regardless of whether or not it's a practical risk. As a result, some offer additional mitigation. Macrim Reflect calls it Image Guard. Isis To-Do has what it calls Security Zone. Other tools may have similar features. The common thread to those features, however, is that backup images and files are protected from tampering. Period. Even the owner of the backup can't modify or perhaps even see the backups created with these features enabled. And if you can't, malware can't. The only way to access the backup files is to use the tool that created them. Whether it be a file permissions setting or some kind of fancy partition setup or something else, the important thing about these features is that your backups are inaccessible to malware. So, bottom line, 1, backup. 2, automate your backups so you don't have to remember. 3, leave your backup drive connected. 4, practice safe computing. And 5, consider enabling additional protection features like Image Guard or Security Zone or whatever the equivalent might be. There's just no reason to disconnect your backup drive. For updates, for comments, for links and more, visit askleo.com/180733. If you've got a question for me, visit askleo.com/ask. If you're interested in my weekly Confident Computing newsletter, askleo.com/newsletter. And if you're interested in helping keeping this little show happening, visit askleo.com/patron for the options there. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.